Welcome back to Primetime News. There are renewed calls this evening for a clear policy from the Ministry of Education to prevent discrimination against students with locks and other natural hairstyles. Advocates demonstrated outside the Ministry of Education offices in Kingston and St. James today to press home their point.
When will the discrimination end? It's the question these protesters are asking following last month's Supreme Court ruling in the Kensington Primary School case. Of concern is the fact that the judges have left it up to the school to decide on its hair and grooming rules. For people like Bongo Joe in St. James, it sets a dangerous precedent. The issue of hair, he adds, has dogged the education system for decades.
I go through that. 87, and Bridging go through that over 40 years now, and I check say, well, that been finished. And now we come back on here, then they discriminate against locks, so that will come out of the system.
At Heroes Circle in Kingston, similar views.
The government of Jamaica still allowing schools to say if they don't want any dreadlock, if they don't want any sister lock, and if them don't want all kind of African style to come there, them don't come, they mustn't come. And the Ministry of Education dodging behind the court, and the court dodging behind the school board of governors. It's a dodging and a dodging.
I've been doing this for years. From I'm a teenager, and I'm now a great grandmother. And the fight still continue.
Officials from the Ministry of Education addressed the demonstrators. The people were told that the ministry issued a draft grooming policy to schools in 2018. It's under review, however, by the Ministry of Gender, Culture and Entertainment. But even with that,
it is the school boards that administer schools within the framework set out by the regulations. So if we want our policy to be mandatory, a minimum standard covered by all schools, what we need to do is engage the process of making regulations, for which we have to go to cabinet and also to parliament to lay those regulations.
We are really respectfully saying that this is not going to be acceptable for the ministry to tell us it needs to dither for another year, 6 months, three, no. It has the power to issue a directive to schools that say, until the regulations are in place, even, no school come September is permitted by the ministry to exclude children who have locks for any reason.
We have convened our local legislative committee. We have reviewed, we have discussed with our minister, and we are in the process of preparing the documentation that will go to cabinet for a decision to be taken.
In the interim, the ministry is stressing that no child should be excluded from attending school come September 7.